Welcome, this is Atemen reporting live from the HTP for HPC workshop at ISC in Frankfurt. And we're here with Jean Gonard from CEA and Didier Juvet from CEA. And actually, Jean Gonard is also involved in HTP for HPC. So, welcome.
Thank you.
Didier, can you introduce yourself?
Yes, so I am Didier Juvet. I am Program Director of Simulation and HPC Program at CEA. What I could say is that simulation is at the heart of a lot of activity in CEA. First of all, it concerns the defense activity, where we do a lot of simulation, very intense for nuclear weapon, multi-physics and multi-scale. It's very challenging. But also we do a lot of simulation. It's a complete transverse program. We do simulation, for instance, for energy, simulation for the safety of nuclear power plants. Also for personalized medicine, how to deliver the right drug for your DNA analysis-based personality. Also for materials, for of course, really, it's really a very transverse program inside CEA. Simulation is based on HPC. We have challenging computing, and we have three type of computers. One is for defense, and we are now installing a Tera 1000 machine, which is which will at the end of this year will be 25 petaflops operational machines for all our defense needs. We have also important computer for industrial applications, where we have a lot of industrial needs from Airbus, from L'Oréal, a lot of industrial partners that are dealing and demanding a lot of computational power. Through this, this is done through the CCRT. CCRT means Computational Center for Research and Technology, where we do also a lot of simulation transverse domain. And the third computer is concerned with what we do through GenC. We host the Curie machine, which will be the Curie 2 machine next year, 9 petaflops machines for academics research and from European academics needs. And it's our tier zero system, which is operated by by us. GenC is the center, computational center, and it's inside the TGCC, très grand centre de calcul du CEA, hosted. So now our next challenge will be the machine for 2020, where we are 2021, we will have an exact floppy class machine for a lot of application concerning web.
Okay, so as you know, well, first I'm Jean Gonard. I am now the CEO advisor on HPC. Mm-hmm. And as you know, CEA has been one of the founders of the ETP for HPC. And I am today the vice president of the board. Today we are speaking about the new program, a new commission program about what we call Extreme Scale Demonstrator. And to explain what it is, just to go back on what we have done from the beginning. For the ETP has been created to be the technical support of the Commission on its strategy, and this for the H2020 program. There have been until now two calls between 100 and 200 million put by the Commission in R&D on HPC, and these two calls were first oriented to develop technology, basic technology, bricks to build at the end a big object which is a computer. And we are speaking today of the third part of this program, which is to take together all these bricks and to integrate them in what should be the first head of line of a commercial computer that will be competitive on the European market and designed and built with European components. The goal of that has been expressed very, very clearly by the Commission in the last declaration, which was done one year ago, and it is to be able to furnish to Europe in 2022 two exascale machines, and the meeting today, and which is the end of a lot of seminars, is to prepare the call for the demonstrator of this capacity that should be demonstrated in the years 2020.
So we have the French program, the CEA, and we have the European program, and some activities like HTP for HPC. And how do they connect?
So the national program, we have been entitled by the French authority. CEA has been entitled to drive the R&D program with Atos Bull. And the objective of this program started in 2013. And we are now in the second phase from 2016 till 2020. This objective of this program is to have an exascale system to bring the Atos in a competitive to have a competitive answer to the needs of exascale program. This program is complementary and completely in phase with the European activities, the ETP for HPC, and the extreme scale demonstrator. Then Jean can say.
So, as Didier said, the two programs are absolutely complementary and online. They both use the idea coming out from the strategic research agenda issued by the ETP, and their result, their visible result, will appear at different dates. The ESD the first demonstrator of European technology through the ESD will happen around 2020. Their result will be naturally used by one of the integrators to answer the French program in 2021. And finally, the final objective of the Commission is to deliver two exascale machines in the 2022-23 area. So both the CEA on one side participate largely at first as a founder, but with a lot of technical manpower inside the ETP, and we try to do the best from this synergy for HPC in Europe, in order to get to the final goal of the Commission, which is to dispose in Europe of the capacity of delivering competitively on the market these type of machines.
Thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you.
Thank you.